specifically Dragonriding. Google warnings, Google this is a lot. How I play. That's cool. I actually know that. Dragon. Okay. To learn some dragon. So this is in the middle of the leveling campaign, level 50 or 61, and as part of that, we reach a point where we learn about Dragonriding. I'm going to show you all about that.
Welcome, friend. Dionysa.
Let's go do Dragonriding.
The sky calls. Fair skies and strong winds.
Okay.
Ah. Welcome. I'm glad you are ready to explore our wondrous isles. Our drakes are excited to take to the skies of the Dragon Isles once more, and for you to provide an extra set of eyes to help them. This is dragon riding. First, you will learn how to glide with a drake and move efficiently about the peaks. Come, let us get started with some quick lessons.
This is awesome.
How fare the winds today? See you up there. Keep your feet off the ground.
Need him.
The sky calls.
It's all about this is what the quest that starts it and how you learn. Let's start with the basics. If you fly straight, you'll wear yourself out right now. So use gravity as an aid and aim slightly down to fly a long distance. The wings will give you the general angle you should use for basic gliding. First, call upon your drake, then fly through the rings and land at the target location. If you become stuck, use the bronze tongs and silver.
Fair skies. For the first lesson, Call upon your drake companion, then drop off the edge while moving forward. You will glide to your destination.
Vigor spent by the abilities and recharges while grounded, so mounted or on foot, or in the sky while dragon riding at high speeds. This is how we. These are three vigor points. And we can flat forward, surge forward with one vigor, and another one flap upward to get more height. Alright? I use flat forward, but that bar is showing speeding, like regaining, because I'm just standing here. Okay. Simple enough. Well done. Yep.
Ah, caught a good wind stream lately.
Diving in after jumping from somewhere high, if you speed boost, fly through the rings to the location from stuck.
Keep your feet off the ground. As you aim for the ground, you'll pick up speed. Use this to fly faster, then level out to reach your destination.
Today. Now, what if there is an obstacle in the way? Play well, you can conserve and you can gain some height after you dive. After a dive, when you dive, assume you'll find your flight path takes you below the landing. There's a momentum to end the course, still aim at the target area. Target area.
See you up there. You are doing marvelously. Finally, a dive can give you enough speed to rise up and over to a higher spot. Use your momentum to reach your destination. Sky calls.
That's the basics of Dragonriding. You're doing amazing. Now I'd like to introduce you to some of the others involved in this adventure. We have made a home for ourselves. The sky top is so will be able to guide you there. Speak to me, pray.
Keep your feet off the ground. Come to the Skytop Observatory. I will introduce you to others who can provide you with information about the other wondrous things you may do with your drake.
Actually jump up with spacebar as well, because I didn't know with spacebar for that. Okay, fair enough.
How fair the winds today?
Show you our foundation here. It may have flown a bit too fast. My apologies. It isn't much to look at right now because it has been so long since someone inhabited these terraces, but we will make them our home nonetheless.
See you up there.
Drake is intensity will change as well, according to what you find. Speak to Glancera at the Rostrum of Transformation and see for yourself.
Fair skies. Glancera oversees the Rostrum of Transformation. Talk to her about how your dragon can adapt to new, unique forms.
Dragon Isles and beyond. We'll find different items that will impact the appearance. I've already picked up. Once you have used those items, the options will appear as available to you at the Rostrum. Okay. Rostrum Transformation is where you may select a different appearance for your dragon based on what you have seen and discovered. This is the rock. Well, I love red, so I'm probably gonna keep that. Scale type light. Ones. Like impaler. Or I like charger rather. I haven't seen all the colors are active yet. Red here. Wow, there's a lot of options. This part might be a little bug. Wasn't really working right. Oh well. Huh. Well, it's not working. Maybe I did hit them. Oh, is it like a double jump?
Ah, caught a good wind stream lately.
To explore the Dragon Isles. Okay, I think I already wrote all that.
See you up there.
Obviously, it's not just Glancera and myself that are investing in these adventures. While you're here, the others would love to meet you as well. Also, already met Salome, who has a special interest in racing. There's also with Rosa, who can help you hone the specific skills related to gliding with your dragon.
Keep your feet. I've already met Salomu, our resident gliding expert, but there is another here who can also teach you about your drake. Seek out Lithragosa and see what she has to say.
Open the dragon riding slow track. Ah, this is where you get talents.
How fare the winds today? fair skies and strong winds.
It's just the beginning of your Dragonriding journey. Keep your eyes open for new adventures and experiences through the Dragonlands. Make sure to visit us at any of those outposts for now and return to Alexstrasza.
See you watch for our outposts. They are all over the Dragon Isles. As you explore, we will be there to aid you in your dragon riding journey. For now, farewell and discover all.
Good. Get a nice little vantage point. Better way to do that, but that was fun. Alright.